I look at the people standing at the mic and think, there's no way in hell I can talk to people. And here I am today, and you realize that you do it for the person that you've lost, so we're speaking for Clay. Before I speak about Clay, I want to speak to all of you. From the bottom of our hearts, we want to thank our family and friends. Without all of your love and support these past days, I don't really know what we would have done. Because of all of you, we were able to get up in the morning and somehow figure out how to take our next step. And we want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for that. Clay would have been overwhelmed without the outpouring of love we felt from all of you. Clay was an incredible person and son. Since he was a young child, every day with Clay has been an adventure. He never did things the conventional way. All of his friends, coaches, and teachers can attest to that. So when it came time to plan his service, we wanted to let that be our platform for his farewell. We've asked several people to speak about Clay today, because if you know Clay, you know he loved to tell stories. Sometimes painfully long stories. We hope that the stories told today will help to forever hold the memory of Clay deeply within your hearts. He died without reason and much too soon. I will miss his morning hugs, his bright smile, and his ability to make you laugh. Clay maximized every moment of every day. We've never really been a religious family. Our church consisted of piling the entire family, including the dog, into our car every Friday from November through the end of March and heading to New Hampshire, where we as a family enjoyed skiing. This is our church. Spending family time, doing what we love in the beautiful mountains together. This is where Clay's passion for skiing was developed, and he later followed that passion to the mountains of Colorado. As most of you know, Clay spent his youth trying to go as fast as he could down a race course. His last few years at Waterville were hard as his passion was skiing, not racing. I wanted to share with you a letter Clay wrote to us on the eve of his final race. As his parents, we considered this to be a gift. I'd like to share it with you. Dear Mom and Dad, as much as Waterville and ski racing can be a burden and oasis of boredom at times, I thank you for bringing me here. I cannot be happier with my years growing up in the winter doing what I loved most in life, skiing. As I embark tomorrow and this weekend on some of my last competitive ski races, not a moment passes where I forget how lucky I am to have two parents who love me enough to provide this luxury to me. I sit in the loft, gazing at the mountain, watching as the gleaming headlights of the snowcats climb up the steep trails across Mount Tecumseh. Darkness and silence surround me as my mind slips into brief flashbacks of my weekends here in the valley. Only the good memories stick to my neurons, like little pockets of positive energy, positive thought, pure happiness. My life is shaped by our family's decision to chase the winter cold and hone our skills on the mountains. It is a connection that no matter what, we all have in common. Dad, for you to spend your hard-earned money and become so consumed by a sport that you know your kids love is nothing short of a miracle. I cannot think of a single father who has devoted as much time and energy to a sport that he did not even grow up doing. I hope that when I become a father, I can reflect you and provide my child with the same compassion and intensity that you do. It's only fair that I do so. For you, Mom, you grew up skiing with your family and also saw as everybody in the STAR plan came together over a sport that you loved equally. I cannot thank you enough for bringing me up the same way. I have no doubt that it has built us into a stronger unit that will forever remember the memories that we have had on the mountain and in the valley. Life is a journey of sorts that is filled with challenges and obstacles that must be overcome in order to survive and be happy. support itself is talking the importance of hard work, respect yourself and others, and most importantly, having fun. Although at times I've had lows, I've never regretted ski racing as a whole. It's an amazing tool for learning about yourself and how to function as an adult. From organizational skills to physical strength and conditioning, I've matured into an adult that I am proud to be. Everything has come to an end, unfortunately. For me, the sport and my beginning of the skills will stick with me for a lifetime. And for that, I thank you. Love play. For all the skiers in the crowd, every time you snap on your skis, please remember play. And when you reach the bottom of the mountain, smile, think of play, and say, it was a good run.
How do you summarize someone's life and the impact they've had on others in a few moments? It's impossible. I've had a chance to reflect these past few days wondering, why do I suddenly depart your life so early? I can't help but think, ponder, and think some more. Perhaps his life was for a bigger purpose. Jenny and I didn't raise Clay. Alone. His extended family, friends, and humanity were his life. He picked and chose the parts of the humanity he valued most. When Clay smiled, you all smiled back. When Clay laughed, you all laughed with him. While I, as a father, rode him like a horse in terms of getting organized, setting goals, turning off lights, and checking off boxes, as many of you may know. Clay knew his strengths and his purpose. It was to make people happy and make the world a better place. As a father, I knew he was a better athlete than I, could light up the room like his mother. Always had beautiful women surrounding him. I was a little bit jealous. And always had a good time with anyone he met. But what I admired about Clay was his integrity. He believed that one should always speak up and do what you know is right, no matter what the personal consequences may be, and believe me, there were many. Sometimes this made his life harder, but I so admire his integrity as a person. I stand here as a proud father. Most days I would come home from work and always find the reason to yell, Clay! There was always something he hadn't done. That wasn't his purpose here. Someone else could turn off the lights. In closing, Clay enjoyed life more than anyone I've ever known. Clay didn't want to die. He was the unlucky one. Maybe the reason Clay died was he didn't think it could ever happen to him. My request to all of you, my request to each and every one of you who lived through Clay's lives touched, judging from the crowd, there were many. Next time you're at a party, think of Clay and don't let yourself or others become the unlucky one. Safe travels, Clay, wherever you are going. I'm looking forward to catching up later. Clay loved you all.